in 1968. 46 years ago that I drove up here from Belvedere, Illinois. When I was living in Ripon, Wisconsin, my hometown in Wisconsin is Ripon. And when I landed there at Ripon, I was a 21-year-old college graduate who had just a little experience working for a big corporation. You know, I was in Ripon in 1970 and I was doing all kinds of things there. Madison was a dream then for me, but it was not on the plan. I drove into Madison and I fell in love with the place. I liked it, I liked the way it looked. 5 years later, I ended up opening the Cardinal Bar in Madison. It's amazing how fast all of that happened. In 1974, I opened this bar. By 1974, good old Madison was back. Good old Madison, meaning a college town that likes to drink and likes to party and likes to dance and likes to go out, because that was the 70s and it was the sexual revolution and it was openness and it was free love. We all fought. We had Nirvana. It was the greening of America. You know, a time when there was still a little innocence, even though Nixon had already resigned, and we knew that the system was all fucked up. And we wanted to change it. It was a gay bar. We opened it up as a gay bar. The people that I associated with in those days who were ready to help me and work with me were all gay. And I was gay, and I hadn't quite come out publicly, but I was doing all kinds of things. I went out and drag. It was, you know, it was just a thing to do. The bar was something I had been thinking about, because the bar would have given me some freedom and income and something to do. And besides, it was so much fun. The idea of having a bar was the best. I had been thinking about it for a while. So I finally one day look up in the newspaper, in the classified section, and there it was. Tavern with kitchen facilities. Decor circa 1912, overlooking the lake, near state office buildings. All of these things were in that ad, and that was the first time I'd ever looked at the classified section. It was really interesting how it happened. And there was John Cook, and he came in as the decorator. He was living in California. He came in with the idea that we put deer heads on, that we make this a Wisconsin tavern. That's how the place came to be designed and decorated as a tavern with a dance floor in the back room with the jukebox, the old jukebox. And that was the idea, real funky with ferns on the windows and some couches. This place is the real McCoy, and that love of that tile floor the love that I feel for the architecture of this place. When we, that night that we opened, we had money to pay those bills. But also, it was amazing when I went home and I took the bag and I opened it up on my dining room table and looked at it. And Nicholas, my working partner, he had come from California with John. Nicholas says, Ricardo, you're going to do very well. This is going to be a good business. You're going to be a rich man. And I thought, oh, brother. But I hadn't even thought about the money. I tell you, this was all a labor of love to make this room be so beautiful that when people walked in here, they just would go, this is the most beautiful place I've ever seen. It got to be really popular. All of a sudden, we had no cover, nothing. The place became the place to go. It was packed every night. Fire happened in 1981 on a really cold night in January. 1981, on the third floor, directly above the bar area, three stories overlooking Franklin Street. And somebody went to sleep and had a hot plate sitting on a stack of newspapers. All of a sudden, I'm home and I get the call that there's a fire at the Cardinal, you know, bingo. And next door, Cleveland's opened up and served everybody coffee, and no one was hurt. And the fire did enough damage, smoke and water damage to the bar, that it had to be closed. And what I had to do then was try to get back into business on a shoestring, because in those days I had very little insurance, and of course I had no savings at that time. I hadn't really learned how to run a business, and I saw an opportunity to get a complete new start. In August of 1981, the whole thing about a new type of disease, cancer, that was affecting predominantly gay men in New York, and that came to be known as AIDS. And brother, that had a lot of impact in everything, because people still went out and had fun, but it changed the attitudes that everybody had, and especially about sex. And that changed things. That began a whole new era. And for 2.5 years, we had a great club. But in 86, I wanted a dance club. Video guy, the video tech, the DJ, and we were set up. We had a new dance room. We had a DJ booth that no one in Madison dreamed of having. House music and techno music took over in the bar, in the club business. And that happened between 88 and 92. And I saw it coming, but I didn't know it as well as when I heard Nick Nice. They were starting to do raves. This is in 91, when the whole rave movement starts taking hold here in Madison. And these are the guys who started it. So that change from house to techno music affected the bar tremendously. The bar became, I took to it. I liked it. I liked that music. It was either Latin music or that for me. And I saw that that was the way of the future, that was the clubs, what the clubs were going to be doing. there were always issues because, you know, in a club, when you have a bar as busy as this one and you're in the corner of Wilson and Franklin and Madison where everybody knows where you are and you have a history, you're going to draw every type of person here. That's one of the things that I have liked the least about doing this work.
So is that what pushed you to sell the bar?
That was a major reason because I, even if it was once in a while, it was too many times. Dealing with assholes. Dealing with assholes is the biggest problem in the business. By 99, when I had my heart surgery, open heart surgery, quadruple bypass, that shook me up a little bit. I mean, I had to change my diet. I got healthy, more healthy than I had been, but had to watch it. Couldn't overdo it. Couldn't be here with the smoking that was going on. But in 04, it just happened where the two managers I had here and my partner in the building, the three of them came together and the agreement was, you know, if I could have probably gotten more money had I gone through the process of selling it, but maybe not, because that was very well arrived at and everything indicated that that arrangement was going to succeed because they had the experience, they had the know-how, they had me as a consultant if they needed me. So I made the decision then, this is it. This is where I get off. The new owners had a great run for 2 years and then they ignore all of my advice. And when the chickens came home, they couldn't deal with it. When they needed the regulars, they didn't have them. Because in times when business gets tight, it's your regulars that keep you going. In this hospitality industry, in this bar business, you have to have a set of regulars. They're the ones who come in your place. They love it. They support it. They come there all the time. And those are the people I take my hat off and I say, thank you. Others are coming and going, but the regulars, and those guys lost the regulars. And the people they were trying to appeal to would not become regulars because they were not. They were here for the fun and they weren't here for the continuity or they didn't live close enough or whatever. And then I decided, well, let it be. The worst thing that can happen is that they will default and it comes back to me. And that's exactly what happened about 6 months later in 09. And they went under and they defaulted and lost everything they had plus. And a lot of it I lost too. The big change since I came back to the Cardinal in 09 has been less of a dance club, more of a cultural place, more of a, with a strong Latin accent. In Latin, I don't mean just salsa merengue. I mean the whole, as I like to call it, the variety, the splendorous variety of Latin entertainment, Latin music, Latin culture. And we got flamenco, we have tango, we have Brazilian, we have salsa, we have the new song, we have Latin American, Afro-Peruvian jazz. We have always Cuban music, always, you know, you name it. It's been not only being played here, sometimes it's played here for the first time. So I'm just fortunate that there's been this symbiotic relationship between my head and Madison. Because I'm a true Madisonian. I came here by choice. I fell in love with this town. I love Madison. Well, I'm still here. I could drop dead tomorrow, but I'm still here. And people still like to come here and have fun. And as long as people like to come here and have fun, then I'm cool. I'm happy. Listen, we're going to celebrate our anniversary with Madi Salsa. Now, Madi Salsa is so good. It is such a good band. and it plays the music I love. And they play A Puerto Rico, by, which was the version of A Puerto Rico by Eddie Palmieri in 1974 and 75, was the inspiration for me to do the Cardinal dance room.
So it's gonna be a good night.
So it's gonna be a great night. A great night.